In space movies, robots are always nearby to help out when things get dangerous for our heroes. They hold off bad guys to allow an escape, act as a reliable co-pilot, and sometimes just carry data tapes around the universe. NASA's own new Robonaut is not quite as advanced as that, but it's hoped he will add a helping hand for astronauts living at the International Space Station. Meet Robonaut 2, or just R2, an anthropomorphic robot destined to head to the International Space Station with a crew of Shuttle Discovery during the STS-133 mission. R2 is not quite the completely independent machine shown to movie audiences in the last several decades, but is the most advanced humanoid robot ever taken into space. Although the robot is definitely experimental, its developers have grand hopes for it, as do the astronauts who would work with it.
Our ultimate goal is to send the robot EVA, be able to set up work sites for the astronauts and take care of mundane, boring, and dull tasks. That way, the crew doesn't have to go through all the trouble to get in their spacesuits and take the risk of going outside.
Before it gets to go outside the station, though, there will be plenty of tests and lots of work inside the station to confirm R2 will work as intended.
We'll make sure everything survived launch. Just do the basic checkouts. Make sure the fingers work, each of the joints in the arms work, cameras, things like that.
Working inside the station, R2 is programmed to be a useful member of the crew, and one that doesn't have to sleep, eat food, or drink water.
We'll move on to a task board that's been developed with buttons and switches and valves that are indicative of what the crew uses on a daily basis. We'd like to prove that the robot can interface with those items as well as the crew can.
That may not sound like much compared to the capabilities of fictional robots, but such steps are a large jump for R2's developers.
Robonaut was designed to be a human assistant, just kind of the same way a nurse would be to a doctor in an operating room. So you can think of Robonaut as helping a human worker set up a work site, tear down a work site, hand them a tool, please hold this for a while. And so we want to use Robonaut in the same exact way in the space station and help the crew out in a lot of those same types of capacities.
We're interested in showcasing the technologies that comprise Robonaut. And chief among those is the dexterity that Robonaut possesses. And so what we'd like to demonstrate with that is Robonaut's ability to utilize the same connectors, the same tools, and do the same sorts of tasks that the astronauts can do on the space station in a way to aid them.
Producing a robot that can work with the same tools and within the same interfaces that a human works with requires you to constrain the size of the robot to a human size. Putting all the capability that we want in a human package has been very challenging.
There also were safety considerations, since R2 will be working in an enclosed space with six other station residents.
The most difficult part about getting Robonaut ready for space flight has been our desire to have a robot that's fully functional and very capable, yet balancing that with the safety and rigors of space flight, making it durable as well as safe for the crew.
One of the main challenges that we faced getting Robonaut to fly on the International Space Station has been taking a fully developed piece of prototype hardware and getting it qualified to meet the rigors of spaceflight. EMI is electromagnetic interference, and so what you have to do is you do two kinds of testing. You look for EMI and EMC, and EMC is electromagnetic compatibility. When you're a payload, or when you have a piece of hardware on the space station, you need to be sure that you don't interfere with the hardware that's on station, or that you don't get interfered with in a way that causes you to create a hazardous condition. One of the tests we have to perform when getting the robot ready for the rigors of space flight is simulating, in a very real sense, the vibration environment of a shuttle flight. And this involves mounting Robonaut in its cargo carrier on a vibration table and shaking it in a way that would simulate launch.
have maintenance for the start. 2, 1, booster ignition, and the final liftoff of Discovery.